Hey, you, I need you to hit the subscribe button below.
So let me ask you, where do you see yourself on this side? Because here's the thing, right? Okay, there we go. Now we are coming to something. Now we coming to something. You said this is what made you stop. What made you stop?
When I saw the Israel.
Okay, all praises. Why did it make you stop? Why did it make you stop? Where do you see yourself on the side?
Ephraim,
okay. All praises. So you know your history a little bit about the tribe of Ephraim? Good. Very good. Now, as we were going into, there's laws, statutes, commandments. Give me Deuteronomy 10 and 12. Laws, statutes, commandments. You ever heard of the curses that happened to us through Deuteronomy 28? All right. We're going to get into that a little bit. Because the Lord says once we learn who we are, we have to keep his commandments. That's the thing that separates us from the other nations. The other nations can believe that they're in the Bible. But the difference is that we are the people of the Bible.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? There you go. There you go. Watch this. Go ahead.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10 and verse 12. And now Israel, what doth the Lord thy God require of thee?
Come on.
But to fear the Lord thy God, to walk in all his ways, and to love him, and to serve the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul, to keep the commandments of the Lord.
That's the requirement, right? So when we say we love God, what does that mean? We got to love each other and to love ourselves. Loving ourselves is not going against the word of God, because the wages of sin is what? Do you know? The wages of sin. What's the penalty of sin? There you go. So, I know you came in at right in the middle when we was talking about the pants and the dresses and the skirts, right? But you got the understanding on that. So I want to ask you, what are you going to do about that?
Pray.
Act out. Okay. And what do you think he'll say? Give me Zephaniah 1 and 8. What answer are you looking for? When you pray about your pants and if you should transition over to a skirt and a dress, what type of answer would you be looking for? I'm going to tell you. He put his answer in the Bible. Because thousands of people prayed for it, but they didn't realize that the answer's already there. Read.
The book of Zephaniah, chapter 1 and verse 8.
Come on.
It shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and the king's children.
So he says when Christ returns, when Yahweh returns, it's going to be a sacrifice. Not of animals, but of people that keep breaking my commandments.
Right.
He says this is what's going to happen to the princes and the king's children. Royal people. Read.
And all such as are clothed in strange apparel.
Clothed in strange apparel is talking about our actual clothing, the cotton, the fabrics that we wear. He says if it's strange to him, if it's strange to him, guess what? We're not getting in because he doesn't recognize it. It's like you coming on duty as a police officer, but you come in a tracksuit and you say, I'm Officer John. You're trying to citizens arrest them, but they're not going to know who you are because you don't have the right uniform.
Right.
God gave the uniform to the children of Israel. For women, it's skirts and dresses. We read that, right? So when you're outside of his uniform, guess what? He won't recognize you. We could pray. Give me that Sirach 19. 1930s. The man must be known. Yeah, 29. So that was the answer I was looking for. You know, to pray about it. But a lot of us don't know that the answers that we already prayed for is in here. A lot of us think we waiting on God. But God looking down like, I'm waiting on you. Because all you got to do is come to the knowledge of the scriptures. But then you got to make a decision. And that's where we are right now. Read.
The book of Sirach, chapter 19 and verse 29.
Bring it up.
A man may be known by his look, and one that has understanding by his countenance.
So the Lord says, in America, they say you can't judge a book by its cover, right? But God says a man may be known by his look, and a man by the way he carries himself. So we know if a sister is in the truth or not, if she loves God or not, by the way she looks, the way she carries herself. That sister has a skirt. When the scriptures come out, she wraps her head. She has fringes on. She knows something. She knows the truth. Her name is different. Her actions are different. Read.
A man's attire and his sister's laughter and gait show what he is.
A man's attire or a woman's attire and the way they carry themselves, they show who they are. Just like a police officer. If he say he's a cop and he don't have a badge and a uniform, how are we supposed to know? Give me Numbers chapter 15, verse 38. This is why he gives us the women, the skirts and the dresses. Thank you, officer. The women, the skirts and the dresses. The men are supposed to wear pants, right? Watch this. Read.
The book of Numbers, chapter 15, and verse 38.
Come on.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
Ephraim.
And bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments.
So with the skirts, with the dresses, so you no longer cross-dress, he says, I want you to put fringes. Because there's going to be some days where you see the pants, and you want to have the J-Lo thing going on, you know what I'm saying? And you just want to be, you know, hip again. But the hippest thing you can do is be in God's law. That's beauty to the Most High God.
Right.
True beauty. You understand? Because the fashions of this world, the jeans and all of that, it's going to pass away.
Right.
And everybody that do it. God say, listen, on your skirts and your dresses, I want you to put fringes. So it can remind you how beautiful of a people we are. Right?
Throughout their generation.
Is this your daughter, your sister? Daughter? Throughout your generations, as long as you continue to have children, guess what? Put the fringes on them. Read.
And then they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
And on the fringe is a ribbon of blue. God gave us a dress code. When you look at the history of our people, the Taino, your people, they always had fringes with borders of blue on their garments because they knew who they were. Now, of course, they started to go off. You get what I'm saying? And that's when the conquistadors came, which we'll read about. That happened. Read.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe that you may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord.
That's why it's for. That's what it's for. So we may look upon it and remember, you know what? I'm not gonna wear those pants. I'm not gonna degrade myself and go against the word of God. Read.
And do them.
And what?
And do them.
And do the commandments of God. Yes, sir. What you got? So it's Emily, right? Okay. All praises. Watch this.
This is from the Zondervan's Compact Bible Dictionary. All right. Women's dress. Among the Hebrews, neither sex was permitted by Mosaic law to wear the same form of clothing as was used by the other. Deuteronomy chapter 22 and verse 5.
See that? And that's from the word of Joshua. That's the whole Bible. Remember, he comes in the book of the volume. The volume of the book is all written of him. Remember when the woman came to touch the hem of the garment? The hem goes into the fringes. That's what she touched. So, we have to keep these words from the beginning all the way to the end. Give me John 4 and 4. You believe that? You believe in the New Testament as well? Okay, I'll pray. Very good, very good. A lot of the things that happen to us is because we continue to break God's commandments. Like, if I'm angry with my brother, and back in the world I would probably want to fight him. But now that I'm in the truth, I know that I have to suffer long. I have to be long-suffering. I have to love my neighbor as I love myself, because the Bible tells me that. When I wear royal apparel, it tells me that I'm walking different. I am different. I'm a different person. You understand? Okay. Everything that was written aforetime is for our learning, to give us comfort in these last days, right? When you look at the makeup of pants, there's a zipper usually in the front, right? Why do they put a zipper in the front of so-called women's pants if they're not pulling anything out to use the restroom? Does that make sense? Pants put on a manly spirit on women. And dresses put on a woman's spirit on man. Read.
Book of Matthew chapter 4 and verse 4. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God.
Right, that's how we live. Every word that comes from the mouth of God, from the beginning all the way to the end, that's what we're supposed to do. And once we learn it, we're supposed to change. Give me 2 Samuel, I think it's 10 and 6. You believe that? Yeah? Now, what are you going to do from this day forth? What are you going to do from this day forth? Because you said pray, but the answer is right there in the scriptures, right? You have to change? Okay. Okay. I'll pray this. Let me see. What we got? 10 and 6? 1 Samuel 10 and 6. 1 Samuel 10 and 6. You believe in the Holy Spirit? Okay. What is the Holy Spirit? It's okay. Say it one more time. There you go. Okay, watch this. Watch this.
The book of 1 Samuel chapter 10 and verse 6.
Uh-huh.
And the Spirit of the Lord will come upon you.
He says, once you change, once you keep his word, the Spirit of the Lord will what?
Will come upon thee.
Uh-huh.
And thou shalt prophesy with them.
Uh-huh.
And shall be turned into another man.
God says, once his Spirit comes into you, you're supposed to be turned into another man or another woman. Meaning, when we look at you, when we hear you speak, you're supposed to resemble the scriptures.
Right.
You're supposed to resemble that power that you have with God. That's why we, all women, they take the pants off and say, nah, I've been turned into another woman. I ain't doing that no more. I ain't got to check and see if it, you know, if anything poking out of the back. If you're working out, guess what? My wife loves to work out. She wears a dress.
That's right.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. There you go. For real. I saw a post. I don't know if somebody could get the picture, but there's an Issacharite woman. She just won. She won a marathon. She does it all around the country. She does it in flip-flops in a dress.
Wow.
Watch this. Watch this. Ain't nothing more of a workout than working in a slave field.
Right.
Our women had what? Dresses and hair wraps. We still are slaves yet this day. God says that we have to rehearse our righteous acts in this land. Judges 5 and 11. Ain't nothing more of a workout than laboring from sun up to sundown.
Right.
You understand that? It's a beautiful thing, sis. That's why you got to get in contact with our people. Get in contact with your people. Learn the truth of the Bible that you are from the tribe of Ephraim. Israelites.
Right.
No more cross-dressing.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission. Minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.